Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome to my another tutorial on Android app development. So in this video guys, I will be teaching you on how to use custom spinner in your Android applications. So in this video I will be showing you how to use the layout inflator to use a custom layout for your spinner items, and in that we will be using an image view and an edit text view. Alright, so let's get started. So first of all, what we need to do is we need to initialize a spinner here, alright, which on which we will be working on. So it's the spinner. So now what we need to do is we have to create a layout, alright, for our resource, custom layout. So I will write spinner item. Alright, so this is my spinner item custom layout. So how I want to display an item or a row, so it will depend on me how I use here. So what I will do is, first of all, let me change the orientation to horizontal, and then I need to get this image view. So we will be having an image view here. Let me change the padding, add the padding here to 10 dp. Alright, so guys, I have this flex. Alright, so I will be including all these images in my Android application. So I copy it and then I paste them in drawable folder. Alright, so here I say Android source drawable, and in here I will have a USD. Alright, so the it is just a sample, alright, for a row. So next step is we have to use an edit text. So I will also write Android padding 10 dp, and for the for weights I have to change it to 0 dp and also it to 0 dp. Alright, and I will write weight 1, weight 1. Alright, so let me change the text to US dollar. Alright, so this will be our layout. So the next step is we have to create a custom adapter. Alright, so I will extend it with an array adapter. Alright, so it is asking me to first of all we have to generate a constructor. No, first of all let me initialize some objects. First of all we need a context, and then we need an a string array of our recurrency name. Alright, let me show you this one. Alright, and then we will be requiring an image, oh sorry, integer array for storing the image views, images, sorry. So here we will write string name and integer array for images, names and images. Alright, so now we can generate our constructor. guess we have to create by our own ourselves. So public custom adapter, first of all the context will be context C, string names and integer array images. Alright, so here what we will do is this. Okay, we have to generate if we remove the source. So we have to include our resource, and let me erase this. So now the next step is we have to implement our method get drop down view. And we also need get view. Sorry, this is not a method. Get drop down view. Alright, this is the method. So here what we will do is now we will check if convert view is null. So we have to initialize our layout inflator. Layout inflator. Get system service context dot layout inflator service. We need another view row equals to inflator dot inflate, and what we will be inflating are the layout dot spinner item and the second parameter will be null. So now we need to initialize our text view. T1 equals to text view row dot find view by id dot text view. Similarly, we have to initialize our image view. I1 equals to image view row dot find view by id r dot id dot image view. For now, we need to set text, and in here we will write names position. Similarly, I1 dot set in image resource, and what we will provide here images I. Alright, and then finally we need to return row. Condition here. Alright, now the second step is we have to do the same here. We have to copy our code and paste that in our getView method. So now there is still an error. Where is the error? Okay, so we have to use position here, and still there is an error. Alright, let me see. Here I am also doing the mistake, so I will write position. Alright, so now our custom adapter is ready. So now here what we will do is, first of all we will initialize let's initialize spinner sp1, and then sp1 equals to spinner finally by id or dot id dot spinner, and then we need to initialize the string array names. So first of all, what we will do, let me see the name. So now we will be initializing let me see. Okay, US dollar. Pakistani rupee. UAE dirham. Let me first of all UAE dirham, British pound, Indian rupee, Bangladeshi taka, Japanese yen, Saudi riyal, Australian dollar, and finally euro. Alright, so now the next step is we have to initialize our images array, integer array, sorry, for images. So we will be writing r dot drawable dot usd, r dot drawable dot pkr, r dot drawable dot, where is UAE? Okay, AED. R dot drawable B GBP. R dot drawable dot INR. R dot drawable dot BDT. R dot drawable dot Japanese yen. R dot drawable dot SAR dot AUD dot EUR. Alright, so now we have the currency names and image. So what we will do here, we will create an object of our custom adapter class. Alright, so we can say custom adapter equals to new custom adapter. What in here, what we need to provide this, and then names array and images array. Where is the error? Okay, we need to change that to context. And similarly, we need to change context here. Similarly, from here also we need to change the context. All right, There is still an error. Let me see the error and I will get back to you. So now guys, there was an issue. Let me show you the issue. So this was the case. So we were getting the error here. So in order to solve that, what we needed to do was we needed to change this to our dot layout dot spinner item, and then I just need to erase that. And so guys, you can see the error is gone. No, so now what we will do is we will just write sp1 dot set adapter, and we will say adapter. Alright, so and again we need to set on item selected listener, and we will just write toast dot make text get application context, and what we will show here is names I show. Alright, so let me connect my Android phone with my PC and then I will show you the output. Let me open MirrorGo app. What happened? So I will run the code. I will run my application and let's see if it works or not. I hope it works. So guys, this is not working. I will solve that and get back to you shortly. So guys, we had a slight mistake here. We needed to add that our string array to our super. Alright here. So I have run the application. Let's see. Custom spinner, as you guys now can see, I have US dollar, and when I select here Japanese yen, as you guys can see, Japanese yen. Alright, if I select Indian rupee, now Indian rupee selected. So if you like my video, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you, goodbye.